A very great and wonderful morning to all here. Leaders are the role models who inspire the followers and motivate them to reach the target of success. Investiture ceremony is one in which we entrust faith and hope in a newly appointed school council. Delegation of responsibility and giving authority to children is important as it teaches them lifelong skills of being powerful and caring, at the same time making them best citizens in the making.
We welcome you all this morning to witness this great event of investiture ceremony of Sri Narayana Vidya Mandir for this academic year 2021-2022. Before we begin, let's seek the blessings of Lord Almighty. Belonging, comradeship, pride, and loyalty. So, let's welcome our school council members with our school anthem.
India, mother, we sing for you. SNBM. good name spread far and near. For in every take our pride is Sydney and dear. For in that we take our pride is Sydney and dear. Is Sydney and Alma Mater we bow to you. Is Sydney and dear mother we sing for you. Is Sydney and Alma Mater blessed by your Lord. Is Sydney and Alma Mater blessed by your seed. We endure to learn, we depart to serve, to take your name across lands and seas. For in that we take our pride as in the endure. For in that we take our pride as in the endure.
That feeling when we hear our school anthem really raises our spirit and pride. It's truly a magical feeling.
Sri Narayana Vidya Mandir has always been inspired by the vision of its patron that every child who leaves this temple of learning must be instilled with knowledge, fear of God, respect for rules and regulations of the school, and love and reverence to parents, all elders, and our motherland.
Investiture means a formal investing of a person with authority, power, right, and dignity. It's rightly said that leaders are not born, they are made. Investiture ceremony is one of the most important ceremony of the school. We have David Vijay Kumar of Class 11B here with a welcome address.
Honorable guest of the day, Sri Mohanan Pondambet sir, retired deputy collector, our principal Sri Rajivan Palot sir, our education officer Deepika ma'am, Sri Pavitran sir, secretary Sri Bhakti Samvartini Yogam, vice principal Pratyu sir, and all our dear teachers, parents, and my dear friends. Investiture ceremony is one of the memorable event of every new academic year. And I am proud to get this opportunity to welcome one and all to this special occasion. I am extremely honored to welcome Sri Mohanan Pondambet sir, retired deputy collector, who happily agreed to join us for this investiture ceremony. Hearty welcome to you, sir. I would also like to welcome Sri Pavitran, secretary, Sri Bhakti Samvartini Yogam, who is here to grace this occasion. A very warm welcome to Deepika ma'am, our former principal. Thank you, ma'am, for giving us your precious time. I do feel honored to welcome our principal, Rajivan sir, vice principal, Pratyu sir, and all my dear teachers, parents, and my fellow students to this very auspicious occasion. Once again, welcome one and all to this beautiful day. Thank you.
Thank you, Devaj. Sri Narayana Vidya Mandir is truly privileged to have Sri Mohanan Pondambet sir as the chief guest of today's investiture ceremony. May I request Ambili M. of Class 11A to introduce our guest to the audience.
Hello friends, I'm here to introduce our chief guest, Sri Mohanan Pondambet sir. Sri Mohanan Pondambet sir needs no introduction as far as Asan Vidya Mandir family is concerned. Sir has been a well-wisher of our school and has been a part of a lot of functions conducted in our school. Mohanan sir had his early education from Kadirur Government High School and had done his higher studies at Nirmalagiri College, Kutuparamba, and Parashiraja NSS College, Pattanur. He has retired as deputy collector. He also worked as special officer, Government Cyber Park, Kozhikode. Besides this, he was secretary of Kannur Flash Show and is actively associated with various cultural and social organizations of Kannur. Sir was also the vice president of Sri Bhakti Samvardhini Yogam, the management committee of SN Vidya Mandir, Sri Sundareshwara Temple, and SN College of Engineering and Technology, Payyanur. On behalf of all of us here, I once again extend a very warm welcome to you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Ambali, for those words of introduction. Leaders translate dreams into reality. Leaders transform vision into action. We shall now have the pageantry of the members of our school cabinet led by our school head boy and head girl.
Of class 12C is the newly elected president of the school cabinet, a voracious reader and an active member of the ECO. Australia.
Moving on to the vice president of our school council. Gautam Raj of class 12A. Gautam Raj has always been a meritorious student with an A+ in all subjects in the AISSE 2019-20, topping with a 99 in English. Interested in model car building, photography, music and such, he has also participated in various national level scale model photography competitions.
The next person on screen is Devika Baiju, the newly elected secretary of our school council, participant of Sahodaya poster designing competitions. Devika, besides being a meritorious student, is also a voracious reader.
Here we have our school head boy, Aman Dilip of class 12B. Being one among the toppers of our school with 96.4 grades in the AISSE 2019-20, Aman is also the recipient of the 0.1 certificate in the social scoring and sentence. An avid sports scholar in the under-14 cricket camp.
Moving on to the school head girl, Samvedya Anup of class 12B. An art lover, her reading revolves around art, culture, and history besides fictions. Along with her love for watching movies, Samvedya Anup is a trained classical dancer and also finds music and painting very therapeutic. And to add to this, today is a very, very special day for our head girl, Samvedya Anup. Today is her birthday, and I would love to take this opportunity to wish you a very, very happy birthday. Have a great day today.
Thank you.
The school assistant head boy for the year 2020-2021 is the multi-talented Kiran Shankar AP of class 11B. He has excelled himself in recitations, elocutions, and songs, whether it be English, Malayalam, Hindi, or Sanskrit. Kiran Shankar is a versatile actor and artist, winning a lot of prizes in the Sahodaya district and state level and other inter-school competitions, including Shivagiri state level competitions.
Thank you.
Our assistant head girl,
Shikara.
Rajiv of 11B is a member of the school choir and has represented and won prizes in various Sahodya and other inter-school competitions, including Shivagiri competitions. A very enthusiastic student, Shikara Rajiv has continuously been receiving proficiency prizes for her academic performances.
We now introduce you all to our squad leaders. Starting with the leaders of the Blue Squad, Siddharth Suresh of 11A and Anashwara Padmadas of 11B. Siddharth Suresh, a music and sports lover, also interested in biographies and history, Siddharth aspires to enter the final round of the IIT Madras PASS. Anashwara Padmadas, a lover of art and crafts, is also an enthusiast in athletics. An adventure-loving person, Anashwara loves to travel with books and music to accompany.
Coming up are our Green Squad leaders, Jayakrishnan Sharangar and Devika Prasad, both from 11B. Jayakrishnan Sharangan, a conscientious student and an enthusiastic participant in various elocution and quiz competitions, is also a music lover and an ambitious person. Devika Prasad, a proficiency prize winner and winner as a member of the Youth Parliament. Her interest includes reading and meeting people. Devika is also an active participant of literary competitions.
Yo, we have our rich squad leaders, Vaishak Devadas of 11B, and Nandana Biju, 11A. Vaishak Devadas is a lover of music and books, a sports lover. Vaishak also participated in school annual day programs. Nandana Biju is an art and craft lover, an eco club member, and the winner of class 9 Baiju scholarship exam. Nandana also participated in speech and recitation competitions.
And now to the last of the squads. Yellow squad leaders Prithvin Prasheen of class 11B and Parvati KK of 11B. Prithvin Prasheen has proved himself a leader, encouraging students of his group. Interested in trying out cuisines of different places, Prithvin's hobbies include indoor and outdoor activities. Parvati KK is also the member of the school choir and has also shown her talents on musical instruments, especially veena. She has also excelled in literary competitions both at Shivagiri and Sahodya. But Parvati is better known for her drawing skills and has won many prizes, including the A grades at the state level Sahodya competitions and wildlife inter-school drawing competitions.
Education is incomplete without sports. Sports enhances the children's mental and physical growth, helping them in character building and providing them energy and strength. So is the importance of sports minister for the school. To take up this portfolio, we have Gautam Rajiv of 12B and Sandra R of 12A. Gautam Rajiv, a very passionate sports lover and player. He has represented our school and won medals in the Sahodya sports meets for athletics, football, and badminton. Gautam loves traveling but utilizes more time developing his skills in football. Sandra R, again, a very enthusiastic sports lover, has excelled herself in various athletic items. A proficiency prize winner in academics, Sandra has also won a lot of prizes in literary and quiz competitions.
It's the all
of an individual. Extracurricular activities increase opportunities, social interaction, and relationship development. So, friends, last but not the least, we have our ministers for culture and literary, Nakul C of 12B and Sandra KV of 12A. Nakul C, a regular participant and winner of various literary and cultural competitions. He was honored with the Kala Pratibha title too. Along with his interest in drawing, stargazing, videography and photography, Nakul also excels in instrumental music. He has also twice received the bronze honor in the International Astronomy and Astrophysics competitions. Direction of a short film also adds a feather to his cap. Sandra KV, a melody singer and a member of the school choir. She has proudly represented the school at various district, state and national level competitions. Besides achieving proficiency prizes in academics, Sandra has also won a lot of prizes in classical music, live music and recitations.
Here we have the newly elected members of the Student Council 2021-2022 all lined up for the big day. But before we move on to the key function of the day, why don't we go for some entertainment? We have our school choir, Sandra KV, Parvati KK, Prarthana KK, Shikha Rajiv, Ritika Manoj, Shivani Sandeep, and Hannah Lloyd are singers. Nakul C and Parvana S on keyboard, Savan S. Praveen and Anay M on guitar, and Gautam Krishna on drums, all set to entertain us. So here we go.
Falling down.
Wonderful, and thank you so much, everyone. After song, one of the dance performance. Joining us is Lakshmi Priya of Class 8A with a classical dance. Let's watch. Simply superb, Lakshmi Priya. This really brought me back memories of those cultural festival days at school. Really missed those stage performances. And after that classical dance performance, we have something different. Aunt Sunil Kumar of Class 9, Sri Ganga of Class 7, and Kiran Shankar of Class 11 are here with a Sanskrit song. Here we go.
Dear teachers and friends, we shall now witness the much anticipated oath-taking ceremony by the leaders who take their oath of office with the promise that they would carry out their duties with integrity, faith and excellence. Our principal, Sri Rajivan Palod sir, will administer the oath to the newly elected members.
Respected Sri Ponnambath Mohanan sir, worthy dignitaries, dear parents, my dear teachers and students, a very good morning to you all. It's a great honor to welcome you all on this wonderful morning for the investiture function of Sri Narayana Vidya Mandir Senior Secondary School. Before I administer the oath of office to prefects, I would like to put forth some ideas for reflection. Dr. Julian Sloan, a management expert, said that academic success alone does not guarantee true success in life to a child. A recent study has revealed that most CEOs of the best 100 Fortune listed companies and the top 20 university presidents never figured among the top 2% of students in their schools and universities. Another study by NCERT has revealed that toppers of CBSE, ICSE, and CIE never figured amongst the top 100 ranks in IIT admission. Though academic achievements are desirable goals in themselves, but they are not sufficient. So schools have a responsibility to develop a whole range of life skills amongst children to make them successful and useful later on in life. Therefore, a host of co-curricular programs have to be inculcated in the school system. We need to surround our children with a diverse but stimulating environment. Even more important, we need to keep changing the environment. A static environment leads to static thinking. Schools should not be mistaken for a tutorial college. Here, we have to redouble our efforts on these lines now. Prefectorial and house systems are an important activity in our school to encourage children to develop life skills such as public speaking, leadership skills, and decision making. Above all, how to get along with others. All prefects take a standing position and adjust your video so that we'll be able to see you. A student who accepts the position of a prefect or the member of the student's council undertakes duties that are not easy to carry out. He must strictly obey the rules of the school himself if he is to see that the others to do so. He must first tread the right path himself before he can lead others to do so. He leads by example. A prefect accepts an office responsibility, trust and honor. It is in his power to create an environment of happiness, security and confidence that will enable each student of this institution to grow into a responsible human being. He may also, if he does not fulfill his responsibilities, stunt such growth. In learning to exercise his responsibility wisely, he is given the highest opportunity this school offers to his students, a chance to do his duty well and fairly, a chance to earn the respect of his peers and his elders, a chance to prepare himself for the wider life beyond this institution. Do you, Master Aman Dilip and Miss Samvedya, the nominated head boy and head girl, Master Kiran Shankar and Miss Shikha Rajiv, the vice head boy and vice head girl, Miss Varsha Divyeshan and Master Gautam Raj, the president and vice president, and all the nominated prefects, come here of your own free will to accept the honor and the responsibility this institution intends to confer upon you. By the power vested in me as the head of this institution, I shall now administer the oath of office. Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. We solemnly pledge.
We solemnly pledge
to discharge our duties.
To discharge our duties
loyally and faithfully.
Loyally and faithfully.
To the best of our abilities.
To the best of our abilities.
For the glory and honor.
For the glory and honor.
Of our institution.
Of our institution.
We shall always endeavor.
We shall always endeavor.
To serve with honor.
To serve with honor.
Those entrusted to our care.
Those entrusted to our care.
In the best tradition of this institution.
In the best tradition of this institution.
And to be worthy of the trust.
And to be worthy of the trust.
Placed in us.
Placed in us.
So help us God.
So help us God.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
After the oath taking, our cabinet members are now ready to accept their respective portfolios. They will now have the sash and badges pinned up by their parents. This is to instill in the newly elected school prefects a sense of duty and pride. Truly blessed moments for all. First, we have our head boy and head girl accepting their portfolio from our principal. Then we have our school assistant head boy and head girl, along with our president, vice president, and secretary, here to accept their duties from our chief guest, Sri Mohanan Punnambetsa. our squad leaders will accept their portfolios from Deepika ma'am, our education officer. Our ministers will now accept their duties from Vice Principal Producer. Principal will now hand over our school flag to our leaders. A moment of pride and honor.
Our school flag stands as a unifying force of all members of this SN Vidya Mandir family. Thank you, sir, for doing the honors. As the flag flies high, let us lift our hearts with love and respect for our alma mater. And here they stand, our school cabinet, to guide us, to inspire us, and make our school proud.
Leaders are not created, they are made. Every leader stands as an example of commitment, dedication, a person of responsibility. Let's listen to what our head boy Aman Dilip has to say.
A warm good morning to our chief guest, Mr. Mohanan Pandambet, sir, our respected principal, Rajivan, sir, education officer, Deepika, ma'am, Vice Principal Producer, respected teachers, parents, and dear friends. I, Aman Dilip, Class 12B, stand before you as the school head boy for this academic year. I would like to take this opportunity to thank my class teacher, Suvarna ma'am, for actually suggesting my name for this post. And also, I would like to thank all my classmates for their immense support. I'm thankful to everyone who actually voted for me during this election, which was a new experience for all of us. As you know, because of the pandemic, it was the first time in the history of SN Vidya Mandir that the school election as well as the canvassing were held online. With this post comes huge responsibilities, but I am ready to take it, and I would like to assure everyone that the school cabinet will work together as a team and do what it is supposed to do in the best possible way, and also see to it that the flag of SN Vidya Mandir always fly high. I would also like to thank all my teachers, especially Priya ma'am, and also all the aunties in our school for molding and nurturing me. Last but not least, I would like to thank God and my family for instilling good values in me. Thank you.
Thank you, Aman. And now to our head girl, Samvedya Anoop.
Mahatma Gandhi once said, "Our greatest ability as humans is to not change the world, but to change ourselves." Warm greeting to everyone. Good morning to our Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Mohanan Ponnambeth, respected Principal, Mr. Rajivan Palot, respected Educational Officer, Mrs. Deepika Jaidas, respected Vice Principal, Mr. Pradyu M., all our respected teachers, parents, and my fellow schoolmates. I, Samvedya Anoop of Class 12B, would like to begin by saying that I'm extremely grateful and truly honored to have been given the post of head girl in our school, SN Vidya Mandir, Kannur. To all those who voted for me, a big thank you from the bottom of my heart. I assure you that I will work to the best of my abilities for the betterment of the school. Individually, you can be good, but together we can be magnificent. The Student Council Cabinet and I will put in our best efforts to uphold the legacy of this prestigious institution. I see this as a great opportunity to instill values, discipline, and harmony among my fellow schoolmates. Knowledge gives you power, but character, respect. Our teachers work untiringly to build the character of each and every student. Teachers, I seek your prayers, guidance, and collective support in facing future challenges and leading the school passionately. Before I conclude, I'd like to thank God for all blessings, my family, and my well-wishers for their love. This world has changed drastically due to the ongoing pandemic, and it seems like the last thing we can hold on to is hope. So let us all together hope for a time where togetherness, shaking hands, and going to school together is normal. May all beings in every land be happy and free. Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. Thank you all.
Thank you, Samvedya. Now, let us hear our school council president, Varsha Divyeshan.
A graceful and warm morning to all. I am Varsha Divyeshan of Class 12C. I have been elected as the president of the Student Council Cabinet of our school. First and foremost, I would like to thank all my friends, teachers, and students who trusted me and had put their faith in me. I may fall short of words to express my emotion and gratitude. Interaction through this virtual environment is definitely difficult for all of us, but where there is a hope, there is a way. SN Vidya Mandir will and during this pandemic. Nothing has stopped the students of our school to participate in programs conducted through online. Though everything is conducted online, I promise to be the best leader and help you all. A team is like a tool set. Not one tool can do all the jobs, but together it can. So let's join our hands together to work with team spirit in the day-to-day functioning of our school. I would like you all to connect with me as a friend first, and then as a leader. Communication through this virtual platform is not a new thing for us. I promise to do my best and fulfill my duties. On behalf of our school, I take this opportunity to thank all the dignitaries present here. Our chief guest, Sri Mohanan Ponnambeth, former deputy collector, who spared time from his busiest schedule to grace the occasion. Our secretary, Bhakti Samriddhini Yogam, Pavitran Sir, Principal Rajivan Sir, our Educational Officer Deepika Ma'am, and our Vice Principal Pradyu Sir. Thank you all for your valuable time. Last but not the least, I would like to extend my gratitude to all the teachers for their cooperation to make this function a big success. Event like this cannot happen overnight. Proper planning with bird eye detail is much required for such program. Here, we are fortunate enough to be backed by a team of very dedicated and motivating teachers. Thank you, teachers. Let's join together to take our school to greater heights of success. Thank you.
Thank you, Arsha.
Success always comes when preparation meets opportunity. Our young leaders have taken up this opportunity to do small things in a great way and to them all success. And after the key function, here we are with some more entertainment. Hello, everybody. Let's listen to the rendering of a popular Hindi number by our girls, Vamika, Shekha, Parvati, and Prarthana.
किसी की मुस्कुराहटों पे हो निसार, किसी का दर्द मिल सके तुले उदार, किसी के पास देखो तेरे दिल में प्यार, जीना इसी का नाम है। किसी की मुस्कुराहटों पे हो निसार, किसी का दर्द मिल सके तुले उदार, किसी के वास्ते हो तेरे दिल में प्यार, जीना इसी का नाम
favorite. Here we have something to add to the beauty of the day, a beautiful semi-classical dance performance from our dedicated dancer, Nandana Surjit of class 10C. Here we go.
Ni sa sa sa, sa ri ni sa sa sa.
Ni sa re re ma ma pa pa ni do ma pa ni sa re. Ah.
ni sari ni da parida pamagari maga sanisa mailai parannuva mayavillu tholkuminnalage kanivai polinju tamani theliyunnu neerige
illam kaavugal taandi enne ullil nee koodanayu
paapani nee sanisasa nisari needama pani sanisa
neelaravugalum ee kolirum
ആരുമാറിയാതൊരു നാൾ ഹൃദയം നീ കവരും
മയിലായി പറന്നുവാ മഴവില്ലു തോൽക്കുമെൻ അഴകേ
ചെന്താർമിഴി
blowing performance, Nandana. You really made our day. Thank you so much. We have listened songs in three languages. And now it's the time for a song in our own mother tongue. Sandra KV and Archana P are nightingales with Gautam Krishna on drums. Let's watch.
was really good. Now we would love to hear from our chief guest, Sri Mohanan Ponnambet sir. May I request sir to speak a few words.
ഈ മഹനീയ വിദ്യാലയത്തിന്റെ മാനേജിംഗ് കമ്മിറ്റി സെക്രട്ടറി ശ്രീ പവിത്രാട്ടൻ, കുട്ടികൾ, രക്ഷിതാക്കൾ, വേദിയിലും സദസ്സിലുമുള്ള ആദരണീയരായ പ്രിൻസിപ്പൽ ശ്രീ രാജീവൻ സാർ, ടീച്ചർമാർ, മുൻ പ്രിൻസിപ്പൽ ദീപിക മാഡം, എല്ലാവർക്കും എൻ്റെ വിനീതമായ നമസ്കാരം. ഇന്ന് നാം ഒരു അതിജീവനത്തിൻ്റെ പാതയിലാണ്. ഈ നൂറ്റാണ്ടും കഴിഞ്ഞ നൂറ്റാണ്ടും കണ്ട ഏറ്റവും വലിയ മഹാമാരിയുടെ പിടിയിലാണ് നാം ഇപ്പോൾ. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെയാണ് ഈ തരത്തിൽ നമുക്ക് സംസാരിക്കേണ്ടി വരുന്നത്. ഈ മഹാമാരി ഈ ഭൂമുഖത്ത് നിന്നും ഉടൻ തന്നെ തുടച്ചു നീക്കപ്പെടുമെന്നും മനുഷ്യരാശിയുടെ സൗഹൃദവും സമാധാനവും അടുത്തു തന്നെ ഉണ്ടാവുമെന്നും നമുക്ക് ആശിക്കാം. അതിനുവേണ്ടി നമുക്ക് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യാം. ഇന്ന് ഈ ഇൻവെസ്റ്റേച്ചർ സെറിമണിയുടെ മുഖ്യാതിഥിയായി എന്നെ ക്ഷണിച്ചതിന് ഇതിൻ്റെ കമ്മിറ്റിയോടും പ്രിൻസിപ്പൽ രാജീവൻ സാറിനോടും മുൻ പ്രിൻസിപ്പൽ ദീപിക മാഡത്തിനോടും ഞാൻ അതീവ നന്ദി രേഖപ്പെടുത്തുന്നു. ഇന്നത്തെ വിദ്യാർത്ഥി സമൂഹത്തോട് എനിക്ക് പറയുവാനുള്ളത്, നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ലഭിക്കുന്ന അറിവിൻ്റെ കൂടെ നിങ്ങൾ ആത്മവിശ്വാസം കൂടി നേടിയെടുക്കണം എന്നതാണ്. ഇതിനെ നിങ്ങളെ സഹായിക്കുന്നതിൽ രക്ഷിതാക്കൾക്ക് പുറമെ നിങ്ങളുടെ ടീച്ചേഴ്സിനും നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കഴിയും. ഒരുപക്ഷെ അധ്യാപകർക്കായിരിക്കും ഈ കാര്യത്തിൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് നിങ്ങളുടെ കൂടുതൽ സഹായിക്കാൻ കഴിയുക. ഒരാൾക്ക് ആത്മവിശ്വാസം ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ, എന്ത് വിദ്യാഭ്യാസം ഇല്ലെങ്കിൽ, ഒരാൾക്ക് ആത്മവിശ്വാസം ഇല്ലെങ്കിൽ എന്ത് വിദ്യാഭ്യാസം നേടിയിട്ടും കാര്യമില്ല. ഡിജിറ്റൽ പഠനത്തിന്റെ ഈ കാലഘട്ടത്തിൽ സാങ്കേതിക വിദ്യയുടെ ചതിക്കുഴിയിൽ പെടാതെ നാം സൂക്ഷിക്കണം. അതിനും അധ്യാപകർക്ക് ശ്രദ്ധിക്കാൻ കഴിയും. മുഴുവൻ സമയവും വീട്ടിൽ തന്നെ ഇരുന്ന് ക്ലാസുകൾ കൈകാര്യം ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ ഇതിന്റെ ഉത്തരവാദിത്തം കൂടുതലായി രക്ഷിതാക്കൾക്കും ഉണ്ട് എന്ന് ഞാൻ പറയേണ്ടതില്ലല്ലോ. ഒട്ടേറെ വെല്ലുവിളികൾ നേരിടുന്ന ഈ ഒരു സമയമാണിപ്പോൾ. കുട്ടികളുടെ ശ്രദ്ധ പതറിപ്പോകാൻ ഇടയാക്കുന്ന ഒട്ടേറെ സാഹചര്യങ്ങൾ ഇന്ന് നിലവിലുണ്ട്. അപകടകരമായ ഓൺലൈൻ ഗെയിമുകൾ തുടങ്ങിയവയിലേക്ക് തിരിയാതെ നിങ്ങളുടെ സർഗാത്മകതയെ ഉണർത്തുന്ന പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങൾ നിങ്ങൾ തുടരണം. അതുമൂലം നിങ്ങൾക്ക് സമൂഹത്തിനും നാട്ടിനും നീതി പുലർത്താൻ കഴിയും. എഡ്യൂക്കേഷൻ ഈസ് ഫ്രീഡം. അജ്ഞതയിൽ നിന്നുള്ള മോചനമാണ് വിദ്യാഭ്യാസം. ക്ലാസ് മുറികൾക്കുള്ളിലെ പാഠഭാഗങ്ങൾ മാത്രം പഠിക്കുന്നതല്ല വിദ്യാഭ്യാസം. ക്ലാസ്സിന് പുറത്ത് മറ്റൊരു ലോകം ഉണ്ടെന്ന് അറിയുക എന്നതാണ് പരമപ്രധാനം. അതിന് ആ ലോകം നിങ്ങൾക്ക് വായനയിലൂടെ നേടാൻ കഴിയും. നിതാന്ത വായന, വായന, വായന. ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ മനസ്സിൽ ചോദിച്ചുകൊണ്ടേയിരിക്കണം. എപ്പോഴും ചോദ്യങ്ങളുടെ കൂമ്പാരമായിരിക്കണം നിങ്ങളുടെ മനസ്സിൽ. അറിവിന്റെ നിറകുടമായിട്ട് നിങ്ങൾ മാറും തീർച്ച തന്നെ. വായന കൂടുന്തോറും സംശയങ്ങളും കൂടിയിരിക്കും. അതിന് സ്വാഭാവികമായും ഉത്തരം കണ്ടെത്തുകയും ചെയ്യും. ഉത്തരം തനിയേ വന്നുകൊള്ളും. മനസ്സ് ചഞ്ചലമായിരിക്കരുത്, മനസ്സ് ഉറപ്പിക്കണം. അത് നിതാന്തമായ പരിശ്രമത്തിലൂടെ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കഴിയും. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ലഭിക്കുന്ന വിദ്യാഭ്യാസം ഒരു ധനമാണ്, അനശ്വരമായ ധനം. അത് നശിക്കുന്നില്ല. എന്നാൽ നിങ്ങൾ ആർജിച്ച പണം, പ്രശസ്തി, യശസ്സ്, സ്വത്തുക്കൾ, ബന്ധങ്ങൾ, ബന്ധുമിത്രാദികൾ എല്ലാം നിങ്ങൾക്ക് പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരെല്ലാം ചില സമയം നശിച്ചു പോവും. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഓർമ്മയിൽ മാത്രം നിൽക്കുന്നതായിരിക്കും. പക്ഷേ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ലഭിച്ച വിദ്യാഭ്യാസം എപ്പോഴും നിങ്ങളുടെ കൈമുതലായിട്ടുണ്ടായിരിക്കും. അത് അവസാനം വരെ, നമ്മളെ ഓരോ മനുഷ്യന്റെ അവസാനം വരെ ആ വിദ്യാഭ്യാസം നമ്മളുടെ ഏറ്റവും വലിയ കൈമുതലായിട്ട് നമുക്ക് ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കും. അതുകൊണ്ട് ക്ലാസ് മുറിയിലെ വിദ്യാഭ്യാസത്തിന് പുറമെ നിങ്ങൾ മറ്ററിവുകൾ നേടിക്കൊണ്ടേയിരിക്കണം. അറിവ് നേടൽ ഒരു തപസ്യയായി മാറ്റണം. നിങ്ങളുടെ വളർച്ചയ്ക്കുള്ള പ്രചോദനമായി മാറണം. നിങ്ങൾ ഒരു വിളക്ക് മരമായി മാറണം. അനേകം പേർക്ക് അറിവിന്റെ വെളിച്ചം നൽകുന്ന വിളക്ക് മരമില്ലേ, അതായിരിക്കണം നിങ്ങൾ. നിങ്ങൾ പലർക്കും നിങ്ങളുടെ അറിവ് പകർന്നു കൊടുക്കുന്നതിന്റെ ഒരു സ്വഭാവ വിശേഷത്തിലേക്ക് നിങ്ങൾ വളരണം. തോമസ് അൽവ എഡിസണെ പറ്റി നിങ്ങൾ കേട്ടിട്ടില്ലേ? ലോകം മുഴുവൻ, ലോകോത്തരമായ അനേകം മെഷീനറികൾ കണ്ടുപിടിച്ച അദ്ദേഹമാണ് ഇലക്ട്രിക് ബൾബും കണ്ടുപിടിച്ചത്. എന്നറിയാം. അനേകം നാളുകളുടെ ശ്രവണമായി അദ്ദേഹം ബൾബ് കണ്ടുപിടിച്ചു. പിറ്റേന്ന് അത് ലോകത്ത് മുൻപിൽ അവതരിപ്പിക്കാൻ പൗരമുഖ്യരെയും പത്രക്കാരെയും ക്ഷണിച്ചു. അത് അവതരിപ്പിക്കാനായി തീരുമാനിച്ചു. ശ്രേഷ്ഠമായ സദസ്സിൽ തന്റെ അസിസ്റ്റന്റുകൊണ്ട് അകത്ത് ഉണ്ടാക്കി വെച്ച ബൾബ് അതിന്റെ സാധന സാമഗ്രികളും കൊണ്ടുവരാൻ പറഞ്ഞു. തന്റെ അസിസ്റ്റന്റ് അത് മുറിയിൽ നിന്ന് കൊണ്ടുവരുമ്പോൾ കൈപ്പിഴ കൊണ്ട് നിലത്ത് വീണു. മാസങ്ങളും വർഷങ്ങളും ചെലവഴിച്ച് നിർമ്മിച്ച പുതിയ കണ്ടുപിടുത്തം തന്റെ ശിഷ്യന്റെ കൈപ്പിഴ മൂലം നശിച്ചുപോയതിന് സാധാരണയായി ശിഷ്യനെ കഠിനമായി ശിക്ഷിക്കുകയാണ് വേണ്ടത്. എന്നാൽ നിറഞ്ഞ സദസ്സിൽ അദ്ദേഹം പറഞ്ഞു, നാളെ ഇതേ സ്ഥലത്ത് ഇതേ സമയത്ത് നിങ്ങളുടെ മുമ്പിൽ ഞാൻ ഇത് അവതരിപ്പിച്ച് കാണിക്കും എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു. ഉറക്കമില്ലാത്ത രാത്രി അന്നത്തെ രാത്രിയിൽ എഡിസണും ശിഷ്യനും ബൾബ് പുനർനിർമ്മിക്കുന്നതിന്റെ തിരക്കിലായിരുന്നു. പിറ്റേന്ന് വീണ്ടും ബൾബ് അവതരിപ്പിച്ച് ഇലക്ട്രിക് ബൾബ് അവതരിപ്പിക്കാനുള്ള സമയമായി. ശിഷ്യനെ കൊണ്ടു തന്നെ തലേ ദിവസം കൊണ്ടുവന്ന ശിഷ്യനെ കൊണ്ട് തന്നെ അത് കൊണ്ടുവരിപ്പിക്കുകയും ചെയ്തു. ബൾബ് എന്ന മഹത്തായ കണ്ടുപിടുത്തം നിറഞ്ഞ സദസ്സിൽ അവതരിപ്പിച്ചു, കയ്യടി നേടുകയും ചെയ്തു. ചോദ്യത്തിനുള്ള സമയമായപ്പോൾ സദസ്സിൽ നിന്നും ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ തുരുതരാ വന്നു തുടങ്ങി. എന്തുകൊണ്ടാണ് ഇന്നലെ വീണ് നശിപ്പിച്ച അതേ ആളെ കൊണ്ട് തന്നെ ഇന്നും അത് കൊണ്ടുവരാൻ പറഞ്ഞത്? ഇദ്ദേഹം ഇന്നും അത് തന്നെ ആവർത്തിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ടായിരുന്നെങ്കിൽ എന്തായിരുന്നു സ്ഥിതി? ഉത്തരം സദസ്സിനെയും നമ്മൾ ഏവരെയും ചിന്തിപ്പിക്കുന്ന തരത്തിലായിരുന്നു ഈ ബൾബ് അദ്ദേഹം പറഞ്ഞു. എഡിസൺ പറഞ്ഞു, ഈ ബൾബ് നിർമ്മിച്ചതിന്റെ സാങ്കേതിക വിദ്യ വർഷങ്ങളായുള്ള ശ്രമപരമായിട്ട് എനിക്കറിയാം. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ എനിക്കത് വീണ്ടും ഉണ്ടാക്കാൻ കഴിയുമെന്നുള്ള പൂർണ്ണ ആത്മവിശ്വാസം എനിക്കുണ്ട്. എന്നാൽ ഇന്ന് ഞാൻ മറ്റൊരാളെ വെച്ച് അത് കൊണ്ടുവന്നിരുന്നുവെങ്കിൽ ഈ മനുഷ്യന്റെ ആത്മവിശ്വാസം തകർന്നു പോയേനെ. കുറ്റബോധത്താൽ അദ്ദേഹത്തിന്റെ മനസ്സ് ചഞ്ചലപ്പെടുമായിരുന്നില്ലേ? സദസ് നിശബ്ദമായി എഡിസൺ പറഞ്ഞു കേൾക്കുകയും നീണ്ട കൈയൊടിയോടുകൂടെ അത് സ്വീകരിക്കുകയും ചെയ്തു. ഇവിടെ രണ്ടാളിന്റെ ആത്മവിശ്വാസമാണ് ഉയർന്നത്. ഒന്ന്, തനിക്ക് അത് വീണ്ടും ഉണ്ടാക്കാൻ നിർമ്മിക്കാൻ കഴിയുമെന്നുള്ള തികഞ്ഞ ആത്മവിശ്വാസം എഡിസണും, രണ്ടാമത് തന്റെ അസിസ്റ്റന്റിൻ്റെത്. തന്റെ ബോസിന് തന്റെ മേലുള്ള ആത്മവിശ്വാസം കൊണ്ടാണ് തനിക്ക് ആത്മവിശ്വാസം ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കുന്നത് എന്നുള്ള ഒരു വിശ്വാസം അദ്ദേഹത്തിനും ഉണ്ടായി. ഇവിടെ രണ്ടുപേരുടെയും ആത്മവിശ്വാസമായിട്ടാണ്, ആത്മവിശ്വാസം ഏറ്റവും ഉയർന്ന നിലയിലായതാണ് നമ്മൾക്ക് കാണേണ്ടത്. ഇവിടെയാണ് ഞാൻ നേരത്തെ പറഞ്ഞ ആത്മവിശ്വാസത്തിന്റെ പ്രസക്തി. ഇന്ന് ഇവിടെ ഇൻവെസ്റ്റേച്ചർ സെറിമണിയിൽ 11th 12th കുട്ടികളാണെന്ന് മനസ്സിലാക്കുന്നത്. അടുത്ത വർഷമോ അതിനടുത്ത വർഷമോ നിങ്ങൾ പ്രൊഫഷണൽ കോളേജിൽ പോവാൻ തയ്യാറായി നിൽക്കുകയാണ്. ഇന്ന് കേരളത്തിലുള്ളവർ മെഡിസിനോ എഞ്ചിനീയറിങ്ങിനോ സാധ്യമല്ലാത്ത സാഹചര്യത്തിലുമാണ് നമുക്ക് മറ്റു കോഴ്സുകളെ പറ്റി അറിയുന്നത്. ആദ്യമായിട്ട് നമ്മളുടെ പ്രിഫറൻസ് മെഡിക്കൽ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് ആണോ? ഇന്ന് ലോകം മാറുകയും മറ്റു മേഖലയിൽ കൂടുതൽ അവസരങ്ങൾ ഉണ്ടാവുകയും ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. വെറും മെഡിസിനും എഞ്ചിനീയറിങ്ങും മാത്രമല്ല ജീവിതത്തിന്റെ ഒരു നമ്മളുടെ ലക്ഷ്യം എന്ന് നാം കരുതരുത്. ഇനിയും വലിയ വലിയ മാറ്റങ്ങൾ ഇന്ന് ലോകം മാറുകയും മറ്റു മേഖലയിൽ കൂടുതൽ അവസരങ്ങൾ ഉണ്ടാവുകയും ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. ലോകം മുഴുവനും ഇന്ന് മറ്റു തരത്തിലുള്ള ഇൻവെൻഷനുകളും മറ്റു തരത്തിൽ കണ്ടുപിടുത്തലും കണ്ടുപിടിക്കുമ്പോൾ നമ്മുടെ സാധ്യതകളും നമ്മളെ പരിസ്ഥിതികളും മാറിക്കൊണ്ടേയിരിക്കുകയാണ്, നമ്മളെ പരിസ്ഥിതികളും ഉയർന്നുകൊണ്ടേയിരിക്കുകയാണ്. ഇനിയും വലിയ വലിയ മാറ്റങ്ങൾ കരിയർ രംഗത്ത് വരുമെന്ന് വിദ്യാഭ്യാസ കരിയർ വിദഗ്ധർ പറയുന്നു. ഇന്ന് എന്തെല്ലാം മേഖലകൾ ഉണ്ട്, നമുക്ക് എണ്ണിയാലൊടുങ്ങാത്ത തരത്തിലുള്ള മേഖലകളുണ്ട്. നമ്മളൊന്നും പഠിക്കുന്ന സമയത്തില്ല, 60 70 കാലഘട്ടത്തിലുള്ള സാഹചര്യങ്ങളല്ല ഇന്ന് കരിയർ രംഗത്തുള്ളത്. ഏതാൾക്കും ഏത് മേഖലയിലേക്കും വളരാനും അത് പരിപോഷിപ്പിക്കപ്പെടാനുള്ള സാഹചര്യങ്ങൾ ഇന്നുണ്ട്. കരിയർ ഓപ്ഷൻസ് ധാരാളമുണ്ട്. മെഡിക്കൽ, എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ്, നഴ്സിംഗ്, കാറ്ററിംഗ്, ഇലക്ട്രോണിക്സ്, IT, അക്കൗണ്ടിങ് മേഖല, അതിനൊക്കെ പുറമേ ഇല്ല നമ്മളുടെ സിവിൽ സർവീസ് മേഖല. ഈ മേഖലകളിലെല്ലാം നിങ്ങൾ അങ്ങനെ 100 കൂട്ടം മേഖലകൾ നമ്മളുടെ മുന്നിലുണ്ട്. നിങ്ങളുടെ ഈ സ്കൂളിലും കരിയർ ഗൈഡൻസ് ഉണ്ട് എന്ന് ഞാൻ മനസ്സിലാക്കുന്നു. +1 +2 കുട്ടികളായ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഈ സെല്ലിന്റെ സേവനം നന്നായി ഉപയോഗിക്കണം. നിങ്ങളുടെ ഭാവി ജീവിതത്തിന് നന്നായി ഉപകരിക്കും. ഇത്രമാത്രമേ എനിക്ക് പറയാനുള്ളൂ. വളരെ പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട ഒരു വേറൊരു കാര്യം കൂടിയുണ്ട് എന്ന് പറയാനുള്ളത്, ഇന്നത്തെ ദിവസം വലിയൊരു പ്രാധാന്യമുള്ള, ഇന്ന് നേരെ പേരൻസും കുട്ടികളും കൂടി ഇരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു സദസ്സാണെന്നാണ് ഞാൻ മനസ്സിലാക്കുന്നത്. ഇന്ന് ഇന്നത്തെ ദിവസം വളരെയധികം വലിയൊരു പ്രാധാന്യം കൂടി ഉണ്ട്. ഇന്ന് ഗ്ലോബൽ ഡേ ഓഫ് പേരൻസ് എന്ന ദിവസമാണ് ഇന്ന്, ഗ്ലോബൽ ഡേ ഓഫ് പേരൻസ്. അതുകൊണ്ട് ഇന്നത്തെ ദിവസം നമ്മൾ ഇവിടെ ഇല്ല, എല്ലാ പേരൻസിനും നമ്മളൊന്ന് കൈയടിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് അവരെ അഭിനന്ദിക്കാനും അത് അവർ ഈ സദസ്സിൽ വന്നിരിക്കാനുള്ള യോഗം ഒരു 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 സാഹചര്യം ഉണ്ടായതിൽ നമുക്ക് കൈയടിച്ച് അഭിനന്ദിക്കാം. ഇത്ര മാത്രം പറഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ട് എൻ്റെ ഈ ചെറുഭാഷണം നിർത്തുന്നു. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഒരിക്കൽ കൂടി രാജീവൻ സാറിനും മാഡത്തിനും മറ്റുള്ള പ്രദ്യു സാറിനും എല്ലാവർക്കും ഈ മാനേജ്മെന്റ് കമ്മിറ്റിയിലെ പവിത്രാട്ടനും എല്ലാവർക്കും ഒരിക്കൽ കൂടി ഞാൻ നന്ദി രേഖപ്പെടുത്തുന്നു. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് നന്ദി, നമസ്കാരം.
Thank you, sir, for those words of wisdom. We now request our chief guest to hand over the 0.1 certificate to Amandali, our head boy. This is sent by the CBSE for a Ascendum in Social Science in the AI SSE 2019-2020-21. Thank you, sir, and congrats once again, Aman. I'm sure that Deepika ma'am, our former principal, would like to share a few words. Over to you, ma'am.
Good morning to one and all. Honorable chief guest, Mohanan Ponnambet sir, the former vice president of Sri Bhakti Samvardhini Yogam, then the deputy collector, retired deputy collector of Kannur. He has adorned a lot of positions in life. And a chief guest for the investiture ceremony of SN Vidya Mandir, who else can we think of as an apt person to inaugurate the parliament of our school for the academic year 2021-22? Let me first of all take this opportunity to thank sir for joining us here today for this investiture ceremony inauguration. Mohanan Ponnambet sir, I have worked with Mohanan Ponnambet sir for a very long time when he was the vice president of Sri Bhakti Samvardhini Yogam. And I know that whatever assignments he takes up, he does full justice to whatever he takes up. All the teachers of SN Vidya Mandir will remember that when we conducted the Silver Jubilee celebrations of our school in the year 2005, Mohanan Ponnambet sir was the brain behind all the activities and the success of our Silver Jubilee celebrations. We worked very closely with him, and whenever we gave him an idea that we wanted to do something to show the world that SN Vidya Mandir is a great school which can do a lot of activities, he gave us all the opportunities and the freedom to do whatever we wanted to and liked to. And I even remember today, I think in this part of Kerala, no other school at that particular point of time had done a mock parliament. And it was with Sir's support that we could do a wonderful mock parliament, which was appreciated by all the schools in and around Kannur. It was a wonderful achievement of SN Vidya Mandir, and the Silver Jubilee celebrations proved to all the people in Kannur and around that if the teachers, the principal and the managing committee work together, wonders can be created. Because I know there were many other schools in Kannur which conducted the Silver Jubilee and Golden Jubilee and all the celebrations, but it was all done with the help of outsiders and the PTA that was there very actively in the schools. But here in SN Vidya Mandir, we got the support of our parents, the teachers, the managing committee, all of us together, we conducted a wonderful Silver Jubilee celebrations, which is remembered and which is written in golden letters in the history of SN Vidya Mandir. So Mohanan Ponnambet sir is the apt person to inaugurate our school parliament. Himself being an administrator, he has given us a lot of advice of how we can proceed with all the activities in the school. I would like to extend a very hearty welcome to him and a big thanks for accepting the invitation and inaugurating the parliament of SN Vidya Mandir. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate the principal, all the teachers of the English, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit department, and all the other teachers who were involved in making this program a great success, especially Prashant, Narayanan, Prathyu, over and above everyone, Prathyu sir, who I'm sure worked tirelessly to make this function a grand success. I would like to congratulate them and thank them also. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate all the students of the Parliament, School Parliament, who contested the elections. I did not see the online classes that you gave for to the children when you were canvassing for the elections, but I was told that you all did a wonderful job. I'm very happy about it. And as I have always been saying, the pandemic is a situation which we know has created a lot of sadness for a lot of people, because many of us have lost our near and dear ones due to this pandemic. But as far as the teaching profession is concerned, I'm sure even though last year when the pandemic struck the whole world and it affected the education scenario the most, I'm sure that 16 months after the pandemic now, when we are sitting in the online classes, I think it has made all of us very, very energetic, has made all of us able to do a lot of things which, if the pandemic had not struck us, we would never have been able to achieve or do. Because I know, as I'm watching some of the classes of the teachers during the online classes, when I get into their classes and I watch them, I know that there is a lot of differences in the classes that the teachers, they have learned a lot of new things. They are applying a lot of things in the classes, and the children are also doing a wonderful job by experimenting and trying to find out new things. But dear children, I would also like to remind you, just like our chief guest said, Mohan and Ponnambet sir, the online platform is very vast and there are a lot of secrets hidden which will be detrimental to your health, to your mental peace and all these things. And I'm sure, don't get hooked to the online games. And cyber security also is a very important thing. We will be conducting a class on cyber security for all the children, because I have spoken to 2-3 agencies and I'm working on that to see that, because I want to keep all the teachers and the children stay safe from cyber crimes, which is very inherent now in the society. So dear children, I'm very happy that this class has been very effective. Dear children who have been elected to the council, this is an opportunity for you to prove your talents, and leadership is attainment of transferable skills or 21st century skills. And you have got the proper opportunity to put these 21st century skills or transferable skills into practice by becoming a leader. And when you involve in various activities and conduct various activities, you are learning decision-making skills, problem-solving skills, negotiation skills, managing emotion skills, empathy, and all the transferable skills, or life skills as we call it, or the 21st century skills which is needed to improve in your life throughout. So dear children, this is a very golden opportunity for you to see that you improve all these skills. And I'm sure under your able leadership and guidance, you can do a lot of things. I know it is not very easy to do many things now because we are all stuck to our homes and in an online platform. But now, by conducting this investiture ceremony also online and the elections also online, you have proved that nothing is possible if you put your mind to it. So dear children, I request the school council, the different departments and the different portfolios that have been given to you, there are certain suggestions which I would like to tell you and give to you so that you can put it into practice if possible. If you put your minds to it, it is possible. See, you know that all of you are confined to your houses, and I know these 16 months of online classes, in the beginning, everybody was very, very interested in all the online classes. But I know now there is screen fatigue, what is more detrimental than the pandemic now. Because most of the people, it's not only the children, but it's the teachers, it's the students, it's the teachers, those working in the offices. Everybody now is inflicted with what is called screen fatigue. Because most of the time you are on the screen, it is not only screen fatigue has happened, not only because you are in the online classes and attending the classes, but most of the time, all of you, children, teachers, everybody is on the screen most of the time. The reason for that is because you don't have any other avenue to give vent to all your pending emotions and things like that. But if the online screen or online platform is used effectively, you can do wonderful things. You can have connections to improve your studies, to improve your hobbies, all these things. You can connect with different universities, different worlds. The platform is very, very vast now. So dear children, if you could use it very effectively, and for the school council, I have a suggestion. It would be very good. Please think of it, plan it with your principal and the teachers and see whether you can conduct. Last year, I had this in my mind, but because we were all new to the online platform, it could not be done at that particular point of time. I had spoken to some of the teachers whether it could be done. It would be very good if we can, you can conduct, arrange and conduct an online cultural festival. And as we always do every year, if you could conduct an online school day towards the end of the year, before the 10th and the 12th standard get serious and prepare for their board examination, if you can conduct an online, at this particular juncture, you can plan out and conduct an online cultural festival, and towards the end of the year, before the 10th and the 12th standard get very seriously involved in their studies, if you could do an online school day, it will be written in golden letters in the annals of SN Vidya Mandir. And I'm sure with all the help and support of the principal and all the teachers and all of you, because now you have all become very, very adept at doing things online. So I'm sure this will be possible. I'm saying that this should be done because this is a way for you to give vent to all the pent up emotions and frustrations that you have in your mind, because it will give you an opportunity to connect with your friends, arrange activities, plan out different things, which will be away from doing only the routine online classes that the teachers and the students have been doing over the past 16 months. I know you have been conducting a lot of programs, but in that only very few children are involved. If you can conduct a cultural festival involving the whole school into all the activities, it will be very, very good. In a small way, because I have attended a lot of online cultural competitions that are going on now of different schools and different organizations, and I know that SN Vidya Mandir is very, very capable of doing all that if you put your minds together. Another very important thing that sports captain can think of is to bring and conduct online health and fitness classes, not only for your peers and friends and students of the school right from first standard up right up to the 12th standard, but you can arrange some health talks and health awareness programs for the parents also, which if you put your minds to, because you know many of your parents are capable of conducting classes for the benefit of the other parents and the children also. So if you can think in this line, because CBSE has always been insisting that we should have the community also involved in all the activities of a school. In that case, I have already lined up with two parents to conduct awareness classes for you, and they have readily agreed. They are preparing the subject which can be taken for all of you, because always listening to the teachers and always studies is going to make you bored, and the screen fatigue and boredom and getting fed up with the online classes will be reduced a little. So my dear children, you have a lot of children, peers, who have wonderful parents who are working in different organizations and who can give us a lot of insights into different maybe professions or different activities or health issues or things like that. I know many of your parents are doctors also. If you can involve them and get a talk for the children about this, it will be very, very interesting and enjoyable for all of you. So this is also one suggestion that I have for the school council, and I'm sure you will work on that and see that it is done in a very wonderful way. You're all capable of doing it, we know. So please do something for the benefit of everyone, because as I told you, the online classes should not end up in becoming very boring for all of you. I'm sure all of you are waiting for the schools to reopen. There is a good sign, but we know that the pandemic is increasing in Kerala day by day. So I don't know whether we in Kerala will be able to reopen the schools, but in the north, many of the states and states have already decided that they will be reopening the classes for the 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th by around the mid of August or early September. But we don't know what is the situation in Kerala. Anyway, I'm very happy and thankful to to the principal and all the teachers who made this function possible. You did it in a wonderful way, and hats off to all those who worked relentlessly to conduct this program. It was a wonderful program. Thank you and wish you all the best.
Thank you, ma'am, for your words. Our vice principal, Prithu sir, will now address us.
Respected and honorable dignitaries present here, Mohanan sir, Paitran sir, Rajivan sir, and Devikam. First and foremost thing, I would like to salute our parents on the Global Parents Day. Because of our honorable parents only, we are all over here, and we are able to achieve and do something or the other because of our parents. So a big salute to our parents on this beautiful Global Parents Day. Especially, their sacrifices and commitment and selfless love really, gives us an inspiration and a motivation to go ahead. And we are actually passing on to our children. Next, I would like to congratulate the newly formed cabinet crew. Congratulations to all the leaders. And now leaders, responsibilities have been given to you. And responsibility means, a sort of a duty to do. And definitely that duty, you will have to do it with the help of others. I remember here, the famous words of Nelson Mandela, who actually said leadership means not one man's show or one man's army or anything like that. It is in fact, the words given, quote it down. Mandela has actually said, if you want the cooperation of people around you, you must make feel they are important, and you do that by being humble and genuine. That is real leadership. Definitely a leader should somebody to lead, but somebody should actually be behind and trying to motivate and inspire. And here I would like to say a few words about our Mohanan Ponnambath sir. I remember his presence takes me to 2004-2005, when we had that beautiful and mega sir will actually remember all those beautiful scenes and everything and all we had for our Silver Jubilee celebration. He really led us, and I should say not lead. He actually guided us. He motivated us and inspired us to go ahead. That is real leadership. And I would like to tell sir, he remembers our mega mock parliament. Then we had a beautiful painting workshop where all the painters from artists from everywhere around South India and all, they came over here to our school. Then we had a science fair. A beautiful science fair, where all the children from the various colleges and everything, all they came and displayed their talents and techniques, and then various other things. And I remember one marathon also we had, a very beautiful marathon from SN Park to our school campus. I remember all those things and all. That, really shows, how, he used to come to our institution, And then, I mean, I remember, I mean, many of our teachers with, I mean, Deepika ma'am and Pavitran sir and everybody, I mean, getting together. Mohanan sir would actually be ready to, I mean, come out with some idea or the other. And those ideas were really, I mean, exemplary-like. And we used to, I mean, take it. So an exemplary leader. And I definitely, I mean, really, I mean, thank Rajivan sir and, I mean, all the others who actually, I mean, you know, took, I mean, our Mohanan Ponnambath sir for this particular, I mean, ceremony. Really big salute to you, sir. Then I would like to thank all the teachers, especially, I mean, Joshna ma'am and Sheena miss and all the teachers who actually, I mean, worked 24/7 for, I mean, really motivating the children to perform such a splendid way. The screen actually blossomed with everything, that I should actually say. And I would like to, I mean, thank our Rajivan sir also for this conception and everything. And for all the guidance and everything support given by Deepika ma'am. If I have forgotten everybody, I'm sorry for that. I would like to thank everybody for, I mean, you know, for their support and guidance. Thank you all. And all, I mean, my dear leaders, just like I told you, be the motivating factor and then go ahead. Shine like anything, online or offline. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. As our father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, said, the best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others. Only a life lived in service to others is worth living. Hope our student leaders enjoy their service to their fellow students.
May I now call upon Anandji of class 11B for the word of thanks.
Honorable Chief Guest, Sri Mohanan Ponnambath Sir, Principal Sri Rajivan Sir, Secretary of Sri Bhakti Samardhini Yogam, Sri K.P. Pavitran Sir, respected Deepika Ma'am, Vice Principal Producer, dear teachers, parents, and my dear friends. It is my proud privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this auspicious occasion of the Investiture Ceremony. First and foremost, I would like to express our gratitude to our chief guest, Sri Mohanan Ponnambath Sir, for joining us and gracing this occasion with your valuable presence. Thank you, sir, for giving your precious time to sparkle our event. Hearty thanks to Sri K.P. Pavitran Sir for being with us and sharing the joy of this day. Our sincere thanks to Deepika Ma'am for your esteemed presence. Thank you, Principal Rajivan Sir, for your guidance. I would like to thank our Vice Principal, Producer, and all dear teachers for the immense support extended to us. Thank you, parents, and all my dear friends for your patience and precious time. We appreciate your valuable presence. Thank you, one and all, for joining us on this beautiful and inspiring day. Thank you.
And now, I would like to request all cabinet members, anchors, and speakers to switch on their camera. And now, over to the school choir for the national anthem.
Okay.
that, we come to the end of the investiture ceremony 2021 to 2022. And from all three of us here, Devika Vinod, Netra Hari, and myself, Suhani Manoj, would love to thank you all for your valuable presence. Once again, thank you and have a great day ahead.
Thank you.